Hello everyone, thanks for checking out the Let's Look Brad channel, and if you're new here, make sure you hit that subscribe button for more videos to come. Also the notification button to let you know when I've got a video. So whenever I was driving back on Monday, a buddy of mine gave me a guy's number, Jason Walker here. Called him up, talked to him. He's actually a rodeo host, and he sells gold and silver on the side. So if you're ever looking for any gold and silver, make sure you either drop him an email or send him, a text message, or probably call him up. That's probably the best viable option. But give him a call. He's got gold and silver. They do pre-1930s gold. So that's a lot about the pre-1930s gold that you need to know about. And if you need to look it up, it's very demanding. So anyhow, I went to his office today. It's only a few miles up the road. We are talking on something that might possibly go on here in the future. Crossing fingers it does, because it sounds pretty cool. They're probably going to go through, actually him and his buddy are going to go through and look at buying collections. And Jason's more or less on the bullion side. He knows his constitution a little bit better. Doesn't know a whole lot about the adventure and the varieties and the error coins. He says he gets these huge bags of silver dimes, huge bags of quarters in, and so forth, so on. So I stopped by, bent his ear a little bit to talk to him and see, actually a little glare, anyways, to see what all he was looking at, what all he was doing. And we kind of discussed it out that he wanted me to come in. I think what we're going to do is we're going to walk in this slowly, but I'm going to come in. We'll buy some collections and we're going to look through for varieties, anything that they've got in there. You know, more or less, we're going to look at it first before we, you know, give a price offer for it. But we're going to see what they have in there. It's actually a new avenue for me, because I think that's going to be a good go at me learning a lot more on this. And then also, too, this is an opportunity to me to start doing live shows and stuff like that. So I'll be able to bring you in live whenever I'm going through these big bags of, like say, coins or the collection dumps and so forth, so on. So that's actually really, really, really cool in my book. Something that I definitely wanted to be able to do. So like I say, Jason Walker, if you want to give him an email, if you're looking for any gold at all, any silver at all, he sells in huge bulks, or he sells in little bit, you know, piece by piece. So anyhow, just to point that out, I'm pretty sure you'll see his name a couple more times here in the future. Like I say, we're going to be doing a lot of stuff online, a lot of stuff live too. So I want to be able to bring that into retrospect. But when I was there, he had a ton of foreign stuff that was on his desk that he didn't want. He wanted it off the desk there. So I had no problem at all snagging it up and bringing it back here to the house. Got quite a few Canadians there. Got some Italian, some French coins. So definitely need to look over these. We got some nicer, older Canadian cents there too. So definitely got to look at those, any varieties, anything on there. But the biggest thing is I gave y'all a shout out on the community board a little while back looking for buffalo nickels. Crazy thing is, he had four rolls of buffalo nickels there. And I didn't have the cash on me right away to be able to pick it up from him, but he told me just to bring it on to the house. So we are going to have a buffalo nickel run through here and bring out the buffalo nickel binder, so we can do a binder fill section here. So that's going to be awesome. So let's go ahead and jump into this, see if we can find anything. It'd be nice to get some 1913s there, but there's some 19, there's a 36 there on top. So hopefully it's not all one the same year, but hopefully it's all different years. You know, actually this one right here looks like there's a third feather there. It's a little shaded over, but that's another 1936 there. Well, let's go ahead and jump into it and see what we got. I'll lay the years out and then I'll show you what all we have total per years, and then I'll go through and look for the varieties. This is the four rolls stacked up. So we'll start from the earliest years here, which, just to let you know, everything on the tip top up here is gonna be the Philadelphia. Everything in the middle is gonna be the Denver. And then this is gonna be the San Francisco at the bottom here. So we start with the 1920. We move into the 23, 24, 26, 27, 28, 29, and 30. And we do have the 29 Denver and then 29S also for it. We got the 30S with the stack of 30 Phillies. We got the 34s here with, that's the Philadelphia with the Denver. 35s, Philadelphia, Denver, San Francisco, and a ton of 36s. So we actually got three stacks of 36s here. This is three of the Phillies, two of the Denvers, and then the few coins there for the San Francisco. Then over here and everything here is the 37s. So this is going to be all the Philadelphia, the Denver, and then the San Francisco at the bottom. And then, too, I pulled out this one coin here. Which I'm not for sure if it's from a special mint set or not. I guess I've never seen that kind of toning, and the edging and stuff like that was kind of different, too. So, yeah. Not for sure. So I'm going to go ahead and look through these for any varieties or errors, and I will bring you back in. All right, check through for varieties. I didn't find any varieties, anything that stood out. There is some damage that is on the coin, and I just don't want to point fingers at if it's actually a DDO or DDR. Like I said, it's quite a bit of damage on these. I did run through the binder offset also to check to see what I can use to upgrade or to put in for something new. And as you know, this binder here only has two pages, so you're not going to go too terribly far through here, which is nice to have the Buffaloes. As I mentioned, this from the 1913 to 1938 there. There is a lot of varieties for the Buffaloes. You'll have the three-legged Buffalo, of course. You'll have the DDOs, the DDRs, which are only on certain years. And then you'll have the D over D and the D over S, which is on basically the later years here. So I checked through them all. It's not surprising that I didn't find any varieties, because there's hundreds of millions of these minted. So it's also possibly that somebody may have looked through them already, which is cool and everything. But we do have some to put in the album. I did pull off the 1920 Philadelphia there, which is going to upgrade the 1920 that we have in here. It's the date's not too terribly, I'm not able to read it as much. And then the reverse is kind of beat in a little more, little scratches and stuff. So this one here, you're definitely able to read the date, more hairline on there. The Buffalo itself has a little more fur on the backside. Did you see on the top side here? You can almost see the horn coming through a little bit more there, which it stands out a lot better. So definitely what I'm looking for to upgrade and make sure the album looks good. So we did pull off a 27 Philly, 28 Philly, and a 29 Philly also. So everything on the top, same thing, is going to be Philly, and then Denver's going to be in the middle, and only one San Francisco. So pulled over a 34 Philly and a 34 Denver, a 35 Denver. We got a 36 Philly and a 36 Denver. And then also the 37, I'm going to upgrade everything. So everything that I have basically from, I want to say it was 1 year I didn't have, what year was that? The 27? Yeah, the 27. So I didn't have, only one coin I didn't have was a 27 Philly here. And anyways, everything else is going to be upgrades for the album. And then move over, like I said, to 37 D, P, and S. And I don't have an S slotted in there, so we'll go on that. And then also the 37D, I didn't have one in there. Definitely looking for the 37D three-leg, of course. I want to say, actually, 36 had a three-legged also, but need to go back and double-check that. But anyhow, it's awesome that he was able to give me the rolls to look through. It was also awesome to meet up with Jason, as I mentioned. If y'all did want to get some gold or silver or see what he has on his 10th rounds or his full rounds, and he sells, I think they sell just straight bullion, but I could ask him and see if they do constitution also. But make sure you look him up. Like I say, if you want to give him a shout and send him an email, just see what he's got, especially if you're buying in bulk or if you're buying single coins or whatnot. But this is awesome that he was able to have this available for me. He gave it to me. It's nice that we bring it into a hunt. And if you like the video, y'all please give it a thumbs up. It helps the video out a lot. It helps it gets it moved around. And if y'all want to see more of these Buffalo nickel hunts, just let me know. Or if y'all know anybody out there that is selling this Buffalo nickels in bulk, basically it's nice to have the 80 or so nickels that I was able to get here to do this. So it's really nice to be able to do it that way. If you kind of get one or two at a time, it's almost like I don't know exactly what I have in the album here. So whenever I get them in bulk, then I know I'll probably get a few of them that I'm able to spot check and put in there. So anyhow, like I said, give it a thumbs up. Post a comment in there if you know anybody, especially if you want me to contact this guy here, and especially if you want me to do more nickel hunts. And y'all have a great day.